What's up, y'all? It's the Maginite. It's time for another one. So, this has been a situation that people have been talking about basically for the past couple of weeks now. But the situation with Gina Carano. And before I get into everything, big shouts to DataRacer117 because I want to be jumping into his archives because he's the man when it comes to getting all this stuff that people, you know, crap all over people. On the, especially on Twitter and the internet for that matter. And of course, my brother Mark from the Gospel According to Mark with the C, because we actually thought about the same thing when, if you see my thumbnail, you get what I'm saying. The eep, op, orc, ah, ah. And that means I love you. And that basically is when Gina first put up the big controversial thing in her bio. That's what I first thought about when she put that in. I actually wasn't even thinking about like R2, which is basically what she was using that for you know, Android beeps. But anyway, let's look at this real quick. So, like I said, we're going to take a look at what DataRacer117 put together for us here. And when you go on Twitter here, let me pull this up a little bit bigger here. There we go. Make it look a little nice there. Yeah. So, it says, here's the bullying and harassment Gina Carano has been receiving. The spectators have been bullying her for weeks, demanding she put pronouns in her bio and call her istophobic and ugly bee. And now they're trying to get her fired from Disney Star Wars. And when you look here, she says, you know, just basically explaining what happened. Say, they're mad because I won't put pronouns in my bio support of trans lives. After months of harassing me in every way, I decided to put three very controversial words in my bio. Beep, bop, boop. I'm not against trans lives at all. They need to find a less abusive representation. And then she also put, I don't think trans people would like all of y'all trying to force a woman to put something in her bio through harassment and name calling for every day for months, such as istophobe, isms, bees, weirdos, I hope you die, or I mean, and I hope you lose your career, you're fat, ugly, come on, all these things. It's like, and I can tell that she has tough skin, you know what I'm saying, because, you know, you have to have tough skin working on being on Twitter. But just some of the stuff here, I mean, it's just ridiculous. Y'all can see all this up here. I'm not going to go through everything because, you know, what she said is self-explanatory. I mean, look at this. Just piles of this stuff here of people going in on her. And, I mean, you've got more stuff here, too. I mean, and more stuff. I mean, this is crazy, right? So, you know, and this is actually, yeah, so, and here's another one, too, she put up. She says, beep, bop, boop has zero to do with mocking trans people. Love and 100% to do with exposing and bullying the mentality of the mob that's taken over the voices of many genuine causes. I want people to know you can take hate and smile, so boop on you for misunderstanding. Hashtag all love, no hate. And that's what she put the R2 for the beeping, you know. So that's basically like I said, for when I first saw her do the beep bop boop, I was thinking about the Jetsons, right? And like I said, big shout out to my brother Bart because we actually thought the same thing. But the thing I wanted to get from that is, and oh, by the way, before we move on, right, I just want to say big shout out to Fat Steven Seagal because he made this up here. And look, I'm just saying, I didn't know that. I put that in there, just, I'm not saying anything. I wasn't expecting him to do this, but listen, Gina, we kind of look good together. I'm just saying. I know Junk's my boy and everything, but hey, my man, all's fair in love and war. So I'm saying, Gina, hit your boy up. that's a nice picture of me and you together. I know it's Photoshop, but I'm just saying, it works. So, Big shouts to my man Fat Steven Seagal for putting that together. But anyway, at the end of the day, I just want to say, all the stuff they're doing to Gina, and it's just like, did you guys remember the whole Kelly Marie Tran thing? You know, the thing that doesn't have any receipts, where Dana Reese has receipts. Now, look, to be fair, right? You had a couple people didn't. The issue with Kelly Marie Tran was not Kelly Marie Tran. It was the character Rose Tico. That was the issue people had with her. Now, were there people who did some crazy stuff? Probably, right? And it was so minuscule that nobody caught it. Now, I do remember they saying that somebody changed the Wikipedia to say some crazy crap with Kelly, right? But that's nowhere to be found. This stuff, Gina's been going through for months now. Like, she literally said she's been going through it, right? And I think it's messed up that you have, you know, the double standard when it comes to it. You know, if somebody say things you that don't say it, that you don't like, right? It's like, oh, it doesn't matter. Woman, female, black, doesn't matter. Dump on her. Just hit her with the full barrage, right? And the other thing is, when there is alleged stuff, nobody has any proof, and it just keeps on, what is it? Like, what is it? You know what I'm saying? So, but here's the one thing I would try to take away from this, which clearly Gina said, this is about love, right? You know, she doesn't, I'm like, where's the transphobia, right? Where's that at, right? But let's just say, let's go for your argument, say, let's say she is, right? How is what she doing on the internet hurting anybody? And second off, I get it, right? You know, you don't want to spread that negativity. But at that same time, I'd much rather somebody show all me their cards, right? Rather than be backstabbing. So if she was an Instaphobe or whatever, and she's putting that on display, at least I know not to mess with her. But she's clearly not saying that, right? So that's my thing. If she is actually doing that, and she's putting her cards on the table that she is an Instaphobe and all that, at least she don't have to mess with her, right? But she's not doing that. She's actually doing the opposite. So that's my point. So even if she was doing it, you could just take a step back and be like, yo, I don't have to mess with this person, right? But this whole thing, but the fact that she really isn't doing any of that, you're taking that time to dump on her as if she's doing that, which is crazy. It's like weird clown logic. But needless to say, Gina, we support you. Keep doing what you're doing. Don't bend the knee to these fools. It is what it is. They're on Twitter. They're probably not working. That's why they got so much time on their hands right now, because we're still in the middle of this nonsense that we're dealing with, right? But all I can say is just keep on rocking. It'll pass. It's because they'll find somebody else to go after in a while, and then they'll forget about you, and then, you know, we won't. But, you know, as far as, like, the bullying campaign, they'll forget about bullying and they bully somebody else. But it is what it is. So, anyway, how do you guys feel about that? Like, share, subscribe, and, of course, hit the notification button so you get my business in the shop. Remember, you can't be good, you do that. I heard that the best bet is monopoly. Ain't no response. Control debt from assets to pets. I stats depleted, and you'll never be satisfied with that.